Hi, Tim for Volt Lighting again. Today we want to do a segment on how to install the Volt transformer. Today we have a 300 watt transformer we're going to install. The installation is about the same as the 6, 9, and 1200 watt transformer, so we'll show you how to do it.
You'll need a few tools for this installation. A box of masonry anchors and screws, needle nose pliers, a large flathead screwdriver and a Phillips screwdriver, a marking pencil, a tape measure, and a hammer drill. Check the box size on your masonry anchors and ensure that you have the proper size drill bit. After you unbox the transformer, the first step is to open the transformer door and remove it from its hinges. Now, on the bottom of the transformer, we need to remove 1.5-inch knockouts so that we can place our wire up inside the transformer. To do this, I like to use an old screwdriver, one that's been beat up and used for this before. Place the edge of the screwdriver on the outer edge of the 1/2-inch ring and give it a good solid blow. Repeat this step until the plug is removed. Now the Volt transformer comes with three different sizes of knockouts, a 1/2 inch, a 3/4, and a 1.5. With the 1/2 inch knockout removed, we now want to install a terminal adapter in the bottom of the transformer. With the 1/2 inch terminal ring clamp screwed down, it makes the terminal adapter fit very tight. Set the transformer in the approximate location where it's going to be hung. We need to have at least 12 inches of clearance below the bottom of the transformer to the ground. And then take your pencil and mark the top pole. In the top hole that you mark, go ahead and take your hammer drill, and let's drill our hole about 1 inch deep. Then you can take your masonry anchors and screw, and go ahead and insert them in the hole and set them in place. Thread in your anchor screw now, and leave about 1/8 inch gap so we can hang our transformer right on the screw. With the transformer hanging vertically, mark the bottom hole. Slide the transformer aside, and now drill the hole for the bottom anchor sleeve. Put your masonry anchor and screw together, put them in the hole, and secure it down with the screwdriver. With the bottom screw in place, you can now secure down the top screw for the transformer. With a transformer in place, we now need to roughly measure how much wire we're going to need to go up inside the transformer. Once you have that, go ahead and cut off the excess. Take your tape measure and measure the length of the conduit needed. On some 1/2 inch PVC conduit, measure out the length needed and cut it. You can use a pipe saw, or even use PVC pipe cutters like I'm holding here in my hand. Either one will work. Take the pipe you just cut and slide it over the end of your wire. Now thread the wire up through the bottom of the terminal adapter that we installed earlier and twist the pipe up into the socket. With the cable and conduit in place, we can now go ahead and backfill the hole at the bottom of the transformer. Let's review a few of the tools you'll need to wire this transformer. A pair of offset cutters is a great idea for cutting the wire. You'll need an offset flathead screwdriver, and the small bit size fits the screw terminals on the transformer very, very well. Some wire strippers. These particular ones are automatic strippers with wire size gauges that make it easy to identify the correct knife size. Finally, if running multiple cables, identify each run with a different colored tape. This is a good way to organize your system layout. On the back of the transformer, label the inside of your cover with the color run, description, and wattage used. Now take your wire cutters and separate the two ends of the wire and pull them apart. You want to take your wire strippers now and expose about 1 inch of the cable. The majority of all Volt transformers are multi-volt units, which means they offer voltage outputs that vary in power from 12 volts to 15 volts. The higher voltage taps are used to overcome voltage loss from high wattage loads and long cable runs. Begin by loosening the screw clamps on the voltage lugs and twist the wire ends. One of the conductors will always be placed on the common side. Insert it and tighten it down. Take the other conductor now and place it in the other appropriate voltage tap and tighten it down. It's now time to install the control device for your transformer. We're using the Intermatic DT620 Astro Timer for this installation. Simply remove the terminal plug from the transformer and plug it into the receptacle on the timer. Now you just have to plug the timer unit into the receptacle on the transformer and your transformer's control device is installed. To reinstall the transformer's door, simply line up the pins onto the barrel sockets and slide it down into place. Should slip in pretty easily. Close and latch the door, and plug the transformer into a GFI receptacle with a weather-tight box. If you have any further questions about the installation of this transformer or any of the Volt line of products, please give us a call or visit us at voltlighting.com. Thanks for watching.